Welcome children. Today we'll discuss all about what you know for two digit numbers. So let us check what you know. What comes before number, what comes after, what comes in between, then ordering, ascending order and descending order. Okay? Now, what comes before? What comes before? What is this number? 18. What comes before 18? Which number comes before 18? Yes, it is 17. 17. Next one. Which number comes before 70? 69. 69. What number comes before 51? Yes, 50. 5 and 0. Now, what is this number? 100. What comes just before 100? Yes, 99. Now, let us discuss about numbers that comes after. What is this number? 39. Which number comes after 39? 40. 40. Which number comes after 78? 79. What comes after 12? Yes, 13. What comes after 83? 84. Now let us discuss about what comes in between. Here you can see two numbers and a dash in between. What are these numbers? 33-35. Which number comes in between 33 and 35? 33, then 34. So 34, 33, 34, 35. 34 comes in between 33 and 35. This one, next one. 59, the number 59. What comes after 59? Or what comes before 61? Or what comes between 59 and 61? 59, then 60. So, the number 60 will come between 59 and 61. Now, next one. 73-75. Which number comes between 73 and 75? Yes, 74. 73, then 74, then 75. So, 74 comes between 73 and 75. Next one. 17-19. Which number comes between 17 and 19? 17, then 18. 18, 19. So, these are some examples. Number which comes in between. Now, we will discuss about comparing numbers using symbols. These are the three symbols which you are familiar with. Lesser than. This is greater than. Last one is equal to. Always keep in mind the open end faces greater number. When you compare numbers, the open end always faces greater number. Now let us discuss about these examples. First one, 14 and 24. How do we compare numbers? Yes, first we look at the tens place. This is 14 and this is 24. Which number is greater? Yes, 24. So, this is the symbol. I told you, always open end will face the greater number 24 and 14, which is greater 24. So the open end is facing towards 24. How do we read this? So these are the symbols. 14 lesser than 24 or 14 less than 24. Next one, 87 and 69. You have to compare 87 and 69. Which number is greater, 87 or 69? Yes, it is 87. Remember, the open end always faces the big number, the greater number. Yes, how do we read this? This sign, 87 greater than 69. 87 greater than 69. Now, going to next example, we are comparing 5 and 48. 5 is a single digit number and 48 is a two digit, double digit number. While comparing single digit and double digit, always single digit will be lesser. So 5 and 48, which is greater? 48. We'll compare. Open end will face 48. So this is the sign. How do we read this? Yes, 5 less than 48. Always we read from left to right. 5 less than 48. Look at this end, this point, pointed end. This will be always facing lesser number. The wider or open end always faces greater number. Now, next example, you see 96 and 96. Both are same, both are equal. So we use this sign. (96 = 96). So let us read once again. First one, 14 less than 24. 87 greater than 69. 5 less than 48. 96 = 96. Just remember, the open end always faces the greater number. Let us discuss about ascending and descending order. You all are familiar with aeroplane. Yes. Have you seen aeroplanes taking off? How is it? It will be like this, isn't it? The distance from the ground increases. Aeroplane ascends, ascending order. So, keep increasing. The distance from the ground increases, ascending small to big number. So, we are comparing this. These are the numbers. Before I start, let me tell you, some of you have pet names, right? You have an official name and another name which your mama will call you. Yes, ascending order is official name and increasing order is its pet name. Always remember, ascending order, small number to big number. So you have to find out the smallest number and write it down first, then the next bigger number, then the big number, and the last biggest number in this four of the numbers. Okay. Ascending order is increasing order. Let us compare these numbers. These are the numbers 25, 9, 41 and 17. Among these numbers, which is the smallest one? Yes, 9. Let us write 9. Okay. Finish with 9. Next, we are comparing 25, 41 and 17. First, look at the tens place. Here, in tens place, it is 2 here. This is 4 and this is 1. So, comparing 1, 4 and 2, which is the smallest one? Yes, 17. 1. 1 and 7, 17. So, next we'll write 17. Then, we are comparing 25 and 41. 25 and 41, which is smallest? If you compare 25 and 41, 25 is the small. 25. Finally, 41. So, this is the ascending order. Small number to big number. Is it clear? Yes. Ascending. Next, descending order. Descending order, decreasing order. Have you seen aeroplanes landing? It will come from there and it will land. So, the height will be decreasing. Descending order, decreasing order. D and D, remember. Descending order, decreasing order. Big number to small number. Let us compare these numbers now. These are the given numbers: 74, 39, 93, 47. Among these numbers, we have to find out the greatest one. For that, look at the tens place. 74, you have 7, 39, you have 3 here, 93, you have 9 here. In tens place, in 47, in tens place, you have 4. Among this, which is the greatest number? 7, 3, 9, 4. Yes, 9. So, the number is 93. Then, next, 74, 39, 47. Next one will be 74. These two are left now, 47 and 39. When we compare 47 and 39, which is greater? 47. So, we will write 47. Next, 39. Yes. Yes, we have done decreasing order. Yes. Let us see counting in tens and ones. You see some small boxes? Yes, one box represent one. How many small boxes are there? Two. So, this much will be our two. Let us write this in ones place. Here, how many small boxes? Two boxes. So, we'll write two in ones place. Two. This one. Like this, 10 blocks are made it into a strip. So, this will contain 10. Like the small boxes. So, 10. So, how many strips are there? Yes, one strip. One in tens place. 1, 10. Right? 1, 10. Now, what is the number? 1 in tens place, 2 in ones place. The number is 12. Let us consider B. These small boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, these small boxes, they represent the number 4. Let me write in ones place. These blocks, how many? Tens. 1, 2, 3. 3 tens. 3 we will write in tens place. 3. This is number 34. 3 in tens place, 4 in ones place. The number is 34. Next, what do you see next? How many small blocks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These boxes represent 1's place number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let us write in 1's place. 5. How many 10's? How many blocks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 tens. We will write 6 in tens place. 6. So, this is number 65. 6 in tens place and 5 in ones place. Place value. What is place value? Place value is the value of a number in its place or position. Place value is the value of a number in its place or position. Let us see what is. Here you see abacus. You are already familiar with this. Abacus, spike abacus, spiked abacus. Tens place and ones place. You see two spikes, tens place and ones place. Now let us consider this number. In tens place you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 green beads. So I wrote 4 below this. In ones place, 1, 2, 3. There are 3 red beads. So, 3. What is the number? 43. 4 in tens place, 3 in ones place. The number is 43. And 43 is equal to 4 tens and 3 ones. 43 is equal to 4 tens and 3 ones. In 43, what is the value of 4? 4 is in which place? Tens place. So in 43, 4 has a value of 4 tens. 4 is in tens place. 4 has a value of 4 tens or 40. The value of 4 in tens place is 40. Then 3 has a value of 3 ones. 3 is in ones place. Here, ones place. So, value of 3 is 3 ones or 3. In 43, 4 has a value of 4 tens or 40. 3 has a value of 3 ones or 3. In this tens spike, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 green beads. 8. In the ones place, ones spike, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 red beads. So 5 in ones place and 8 in tens place. The number is 85. 85 has 8 tens and 5 ones. 85. Remember 85. 85 is equal to 8 tens and 5 ones. Let us look at the place value now. Place value of 8 here. Where is it? It is in tens place. So, the place value of 8 is 8 tens. The place value of 8 in 85 is 80. Then, 5 is in ones place. The place value of 5 in 85 is 5. 5 ones. It is in ones place. So 5 ones or 5. In 85, the value of 8 in 85 is 80. The value of 5 in 85 is 5. 85 is equal to 8 tens and 5 ones. The place value of 8 in number 85 is 80. The place value of number 5 in the number 85 is 5. Now let us look at this number. Here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 beats in tens place. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 beats in ones place. So 8 in ones place and 5 in tens place. The number is 58. 8 in ones place and 5 in tens place. 58. 58 is equal to 5 tens and 8 ones. 5 tens. 58 is equal to 5 tens and 8 ones. So, what is the place value of 5? The place value of 5 in 58 is 50. It is in tens place. 5 tens, 50. The place value of 8. 8 is in ones place. So, the place value of 8 in 58 is 8. 58, the number 58 is equal to 5 tens and 8 ones. The place value of 5 in 58 is 50. The place value of 8 in 58 is 8. When we work out more examples, it will be clear to you. Let us move on to some examples. Write the place value of the digit in red. The number is 62. I have written 6 in red color. You need to tell me what is the place value of this digit, which is in red color. The number is 62. The number in red is 6. Which place 6 is in? Yes, tens place. So, the place value of 6 is 60. Let me write 60. Here, second number, 30. 30, 3 tens and 0 ones. The number in red color is ones place number. What is the value of 0 in ones place? 0. Now, next number, 26. 26 is equal to 2 tens and 6 ones. The number in red color is 2. And 2 is in which place? Tens place. 2 tens and 6 ones. The place value of 2 in 26 is 20. Next example, 71. 71 is equal to 7 tens and 1 ones. Here you see the red color in ones place. 1 is in ones place. The value of 1 in 71 is 1. Yes. Next number, 78. 78 is equal to 7 tens and 8 ones. 8 is in ones place, 7 is in tens place. 78, 7 tens and 8 ones. Here the red color goes to 7 in tens place. So the value of 7 in 78 is seven tens or 70. Next, what is this number? 11. 11 is equal to 110 and 11. The number in red color is in ones place. What is the value of 1 in 11? Here, this one. Yes, it is in ones place. So, value of 1 colored in red, it is in ones place. So, the value of 1 is 1. Yes.